We're going to come in now with Peter Cook and the chairman of the FDIC. Lots going on in Washington. Peter Cook, why don't you introduce Chairman Bair?
Thank you very much, Tom Keene. I am joined by the FDIC Chair, Sheila Bair. Thank you for the time today. A big day today for Dodd-Frank in terms of the implementation, putting some meat to the bones of all these rules out there. You've got a Financial Stability Oversight Council meeting. You're a member of that. That's important. Third meeting. You've got your own FDIC meeting. Let me talk about the FSOC, first of all. Systemically important institutions. You're going to put out a proposal, the council as a whole, trying to identify, make clear, what firms would be systemically important, what firms will not. Tell me, are you confident that this rule is indeed tough enough and will go far enough?
Well, we'll put out some criteria that we will look at in determining whether an entity is systemic or not, and it's a determination that the entire council needs to make. I think there are a bit different perspectives, but as always, we try to come together and hopefully have a good middle ground with this proposal. The FDIC's main concern is that we want to make sure there's plenty of ability to advance plan if a systemic entity has to go into our liquidation process. You know, during the crisis, we had a lot of institutions at the last minute come in and become bank holding companies, and we were caught with the ability to have very little information, and we ended up providing support like debt guarantees. And so we're planners here. We like information. And so I think what we really don't want is a Friday afternoon call where, you know, institution X is in trouble. We think it needs to go into orderly liquidation. It hasn't been designated. There's been no supervisory process. There's been no advanced information. That's really our concern. So we do think there we do need to look at it from that perspective. And, you know, the orderly liquidation process will work the best if we have plenty of advance planning. The statute provides for living wills, these resolution plans, to be submitted by any entity that's determined to be systemic. So that's our concern about this. And yes, so we probably do want a little broader designation than maybe others would like to see.
Do you think it's going to be abundantly clear to market participants, whether I'm a hedge fund or a large private equity firm, whether or not I meet this test of being systemically important after this proposal is put out today?
Well, I think they will look at factors. No, there won't be any bright line. For me, it's particularly about interconnectedness. Who else do you bring down if you go down? I think that's a key requirement. And we may need somewhat of a two-step process. So there's some simple metrics based on sheer size as publicly available information. Then we might need a second tier of further analysis from them about who else gets in trouble if they go down. I think interconnectedness, at least for us, is really a key. So, no, I think it's going to be an ongoing process. There may be some where it's obvious, others where there's a margin, and we're going to need to get more information.
All right. I know Tom Keene has a question for you as well, Chairman Bair.
Chairman Bair, I'm sitting here with Jeffrey Sachs at Columbia University, who looked at the exogenous shocks of Russia many decades ago in experiments gone awry. Can Dodd-Frank be an experiment that goes so awry that we end up with Wall Street exiting to other geographies like Zurich or London?
No, I don't think so. I think there's been a lot of international coordination on regulation. Everybody is moving forward with resolution plans, with requirements for systemic entities to have living wills, for designated entities as systemic. So, no, I think there are a few discrete areas where there are differences, but for the most part, people are doing what the U.S. is doing. I think Dodd-Frank actually was a thought leader. A lot of the provisions that are in Dodd-Frank are being followed now by other jurisdictions. So I don't think that's going to be the case. I think there's been a lot of work to assure international coordination and harmonization to the extent it's possible.
Chairman Bair, let me follow up. And another issue that's on the table for the Oversight Council today is the Volcker Rule.
Right.
You're expected or could get a study back today on implementing the Volcker Rule. I want to get your sense. How clear is this study going to be in terms of what exactly is proprietary trading? It's been an open question. How do you define it? Will we get a clear definition?
Well, I think you will get to greater clarity. This is a study to inform the rulemaking process that will start and must be completed 9 months after the study comes out. So I think you will be looking at quantitative metrics that will trigger more detailed examination. I think you'll be looking at if firms are taking positions that look like they might be proprietary. Are they making or losing money on that? Are they making a lot of money or losing a lot of money on that? Are they hedged? Are they leaving these positions exposed? I think there are some quantitative, more bright line metrics can be used to at least trigger further examination. And so, again, we're trying to provide more clarity to the market, more clarity to participants. I don't think there'll be any surprises in the study. It's a pretty tough study. But again, you know, the flip side is not to do anything. And speculative proprietary trading, was a factor in this financial crisis. crisis, and we certainly don't want insured deposits to be used for proprietary speculative position taking. So it's a good rule, and is it easy? No, but I think the study will provide a lot of clarity.
Really quickly, let me just ask you finally, there's a threat out there from Republicans up on Capitol Hill in the House that they might be prepared to defund aspects of Dodd-Frank going forward. What do you make of that threat, and what's your message to them in response?
Well, I guess I don't want to respond to that. I think all the agencies are working very hard to do this in a balanced way. I think Dodd-Frank is not a perfect bill, but we're a lot better having it than not having it. There's some very key landmark provisions that address, I think, what were obvious shortcomings in the regulatory structure leading into this crisis. So I hope Congress should demand oversight. They should demand accountability. But I think I hope that they will also be supportive on a bipartisan basis to recognize there were significant regulatory failures going into this crisis that really need to be addressed.
Chairman Bair, as always, we thank you for the time. And Tom, we'll send it back to you in New York. Busy day here in Washington for Dodd-Frank.